Hello, good morning, happy Monday, wherever you are. My name is Irina Shehovtsov. I'm transformational coach and I help women recover after breakup. And today I'm continuing my live series of breakup recovery advice. Today we are talking about do's and don'ts after breakup. What are some of the things you should be doing and should not be doing? Well, first of and foremost is prioritizing self-care. Each day, do something that brings you joy, nurtures you, like exercise or nutrition or meditate or cook something satisfying. Help you process your feelings. It's important to not drown in your feelings. And it's important to recognize that you cannot drown your sorrows in a glass of wine or in something short-lived. We need to establish a practice of good behaviors, of good routines that is sustainable. Do those things for yourself. Whether it's baking, cooking, singing, dancing, taking a walk, meditating, but something that will nourish your soul and your body and your mind. Do that for yourself. Try to get enough sleep. Sleep is very important. It's restorative. It helps you cope with pain, with breakup, and sometimes it can be the answer, a short answer, but it's establishing your routine, your daily habits that you do for yourself. Because once your partner is no longer there, not in the same space with you, it becomes a totally different story. How you start your day, you want to change stuff for the better, for the more healthier you. And express your feelings. It's common to experience a lot of emotions after breakup, like anger, sadness, grief, confusion, and loneliness. So it helps to acknowledge those feelings. And how do you do that? Just simply journaling or writing them down, expressing your emotions on paper, not holding them in you, because you're not doing anybody any good when you hold to your emotions close and dear to your heart. Let them out on paper, express them. Because what happens when you hold on to them, when they are inside of you, and you're not expressing them, they can manifest in a disease, in an unhealthy habits, in unhealthy relationships. You might get sick. Because we are energetic beings, and when we hold on to negative things of the past, they stay with us. And they manifest in other areas. Because for your mind, it doesn't matter when something happened before in the past, or if something happened presently in the now, or if it's in the future and you're anxious about it. For your mind, it doesn't matter, because same parts of your brain light up anytime you experience an emotion, a feeling, a thought, whether it came from the past or from the present, does not matter. For your mind, it takes everything literally and personally. So it's important to recognize that fact. And once you know that, start journaling. Start telling how you feel. Write out what happened for yourself. Some of the things you shouldn't be doing after a breakup is getting yourself into another relationship. And sometimes you might want to feel a void that you have, that especially if you spend a long time being with someone and now you have this hole formed deep inside of you and you don't want to feel empty anymore, you want to fill that hole. Well, hold on there. First, spend time with yourself. Understand what it is that you want. Because by you going out and just filling the space with someone else, all you're going to do is, maybe it's going to be a temporary fix, or maybe you're going to get into the same kind of relationship. The face might look different, or the person might look different, but the patterns and the things that triggered you, it all can be the same. So it's important after the breakup to recognize what are some of the things that you want in a relationship. What kind of person do you want to be and you show up as for this relationship? What are some of the things that are non-negotiable? What are some of the things that should never be tolerated, no matter who it is? Yes, I understand. We come into each other's lives when it's a partnership from two different walks of life, from two different values, and we need to make a compromise. But remember, the compromises that you make, they could be big, they could be small, but once you start making those compromises, a year later you're gonna turn around and you're gonna not recognize who you are, you're gonna lose your identity, you're gonna ask yourself, how did I allow this to happen? Because all along the way, during the year, the little warning bells that were going off in your head, you let them go. You let them go as an inconsequential, as if it doesn't matter, because you don't want to quarrel. But you do. You need to speak up. You need to voice your opinion. You need to let other people know how you need to be treated, how you want to be treated, and how do you show up. Because when you don't speak up, people assume this is how it is, and this is okay. So do express, set boundaries, and express your emotions about how you feel, what you do, what kind of person you want in your life, and what kind of person do you need to be to attract that person that is perfect for you, because we are all different. Another point I want to make is it's okay to ask for help. Because breakups are often rough, and friends and family, yes, they can help you and they can support you, but if they have never been in the situation you are in, how can they understand where you're coming from? How can they understand your feelings and emotions? Yes, they are helping you from a place of support and hope and love for you because they are your family, but truthfully, they don't know how you're feeling. They don't know, they haven't walked your path, they haven't been in your shoes. And it's especially important to reach out if you feel depressed, if you feel sad, if you feel thoughts of hurting yourself, if you keep trying to contact your ex or think about contacting them often. I want you to know that you're not alone, that I have been there where you are. And if you feel you are struggling, if you feel lonely, if you feel broken, please do reach out. And I can help you. I'm opening up my coaching practice, and the space is very limited. It's only two people in the program, and it's one-on-one, face-to-face coaching that I'm able to provide. So if you feel broken, if you feel depressed after a breakup, do reach out. And we'll see how I can help you. In the meantime, have an amazing day wherever you are. Have an awesome week. Remember that you are limitless. The only person standing in the way of your success is you. And once you recognize that, you'll be able to move forward much faster. So, have an amazing day. Thank you for tuning in. If you found value in this message, feel free to share with a friend and have an awesome rest of your week.